Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the School of Life Sciences, I cordially welcome Mr. Lakshmikant Sugandhi and Mr. Sunil Chitlunga, the Associate Vice President and Vice President of Business Development at Group Pharmaceuticals Bangalore. Group Pharmaceuticals is an innovative pharmaceutical company having a proven experience of over 40 years in the field of dental and oral care. They are dedicated to over 800 employees, their families, and all our stakeholders. They are driven by the purpose of delivering the best for oral health, growth, and well-being of the society at large. So now I'd request Mr. Chitlunga to share his valuable words with us.
Thank you very much. So greetings to all. Special greetings to Dr. Lokesh, Dr. Kiran, Dr. Jayashankar. Cheerful greetings to all the Sunday morning attendees, the students. Very good. You are serious about your career. So you have come here on a Sunday morning. Very nice. So let us discuss the concept of career or occupation for a few minutes. And I will wrap up in about 15 minutes. So Group Pharmaceuticals is dedicated to healthy smiles that matter. And as we are aware, a lot of interesting trends are happening in the market as far as technology is concerned, quality, human resource, and the future outlook is very, very bright in the pharmaceutical sector. So for all the students who want to do career building, this is a very good option. Pharmaceutical science is a recession-proof industry. You will always get jobs in this. And there is, in particular, the marketing field, there is a very good lineup of various types of designations that you can take. And there is a sure ladder of growth for you. So 100% guaranteed career success, I dare say, with the pharmaceutical sector. Now, this pharmaceutical sector, I've already given two or three slides in my last session with you people. So I will just revise them. Just two or three slides. So this is the third largest in terms of volume in the world. So if we are producing 100 units of various pharmaceutical products, then that is the third largest in the entire world. But value-wise, we are either 13th or 14th. The reason is we are top in making affordable medicines. So our products are shipped across to all the 220 countries. And our country has got the largest number of US FDA approved manufacturing plants outside USA. So obviously, the entire pharmaceutical industry and the sector is doing a great job on the global scale. In fact, Cipla is documented to have saved 1 crore lives in Africa through their affordable anti-AIDS medications. And across the world, India makes 92% of the anti-AIDS medications. And we make more than 90% of the formulations for antiretroviral, antitubercular, antimalarial, etc. Around 50 to 60% of the global demand for vaccines is met by Indian pharmaceutical sector. Every third child in the globe who is vaccinated through the WHO program is with an Indian vaccine. Every fifth tablet, capsule, or injectable generic drug that is used in the world or sold across is manufactured in India. So obviously, this has stimulated Medicine Sans Frontiers, MSF. They were inspired to call the country as the global pharmacy of the world. And today, because of various technological trendings, why I'm giving you this insight is, you'll have to have a mindset to obtain a career understanding all these trendings. One is the prescription market. The second is the pure over-the-counter market. But there is also a growth of what is called as the OTX market. OTX stands for the mix of over-the-counter and the prescription market. So when you are making your career plans, try to understand these trendings, because knowledge is what powers your thinking process. The mindset will get only through the knowledge which you are feeding. So understand these trendings, and automatically your career plans will start to happen. Earlier, the market for personal hygiene products was not that great before the COVID-19. But COVID-19 disruption completely changed the market scenario. Today, consumers are thronging to get the sanitizers, and they are getting various other types of personal hygiene products. And this demand is continuing to increase and there is a lot of brand clutter. In fact, the dental products also is growing because the mouth is the gateway to health. In fact, if the oral care is of good prominence, then the overall health of the body is well taken care. Today, the global dental market is going to grow to a value of $37 billion, and implant treatments, etc., are increasing. Of course, the toothpaste market is the largest one. In fact, in India, it is 10,000 crores plus toothpaste market, and the total oral care market is around 15,000 crores. And many of the products operate in the OTX market. That means over-the-counter selling and prescription. So this is an interesting scenario. So when you are doing the career building, again, I repeat, please maintain these market trendings, the technological trendings, the quality control trendings, etc. So oral care market is a very happening place. The CAGR is of 4.7%, and there is a lot of growth assured. Wherever there is growth, the thumb rule, there are a lot of jobs happening. So whether it is the marketing field or whether it is in the different other aspects of the pharmaceutical sector, there are lots of jobs happening, but you should have certain qualities to ensure that you get those jobs. Today, various pharmaceutical companies are giving a lot of emphasis to promote products to the chemists also. So that is one interesting new trending in the marketplace. So what does it indicate? You need to have certain skill sets which will help you, if you get into the marketing domain, to communicate with the chemists as well as the doctors. And this way your continuum of communication skills will be enhanced. So if you want to get a job, generally speaking, what are the attributes that are required? There are three important C's. One is character, competence, and commitment. I repeat, character, competence, and commitment. Yes, character is the bedrock of every decision-making process, because people will want to know what sort of characteristics and what grounding you have, including the moral qualities, based on which the job can be assigned to you. If, for example, a person is non-punctual and he is not able to provide timely assignments of the deliverables, obviously he will not get that much prominence in that job function. So please understand, character is the bedrock, particularly punctuality, integrity. So there is also a saying which says that integrity, intelligence, and energy, these are the three important qualities for getting a good job and good career growth. Integrity means there should be an integrity between what you think, what you speak, and what you do. So that will create a transparency between you and your supervisor, or it could be with your customer. So if this integrity is established, a lot of trust and reliability will be on you. And many other things happen because of trust and reliability on an individual or an organization. Next is the intelligence. Intelligence is not just about the ability to reason. It is also the amount of memory you are having, the amount of knowledge that you are having, because knowledge is what is getting processed as reasoning to produce an output. So you have integrity, you have intelligence, and you should have the energy. Energy is not just the physical energy. It is that intense emotional energy. That is the enthusiasm, which is the rocket fuel of your achievements in various career tracks. So maintain this three formula, which is the integrity, intelligence, and energy, to power ahead in your career life. So if you also see the three C's on which the assessment of the interviewee is done by the job interviewer, and that is the character, the competence, and the commitment. Along with that, he will check your confidence, the creativity, and communication skill. So these are the six C's which are very vital for you to get a good career growth. So when you say character, I re-emphasize, it is the integrity, it is the punctuality, it is the loyalty, or it is your dedicated aspect, which becomes a part of you. A person who is reliable and trusted always will have very good innings in his career. Competence. Competence is not only your syllabus-oriented competence, but also the general knowledge, your social ethics, your ability to move with people. So all these aspects are important. It's the ability to do something successfully or efficiently. You should demonstrate that you have that knowledge or skill, because of which the person will be inspired to take you on board for that job. So competence is a very important aspect. Next is commitment. What is commitment? When you are given an assignment, you are able to dedicate yourself to that cause to see the deliverable is achieved. Many a times people are lackadaisical in their attitude. We see that in our entire process. So please do your state of commitment to a particular issue, target, or whatever assignment that you have been given. Demonstrate it to the interviewer. Yes, confidence or fearlessness is a very important aspect. When you don't have any fear in you to do a particular job, and if you don't have any fear in you for experiencing a certain event, obviously the person who is around you will also get inspired with that sense of fearlessness. Confidence basically means absence of fear. Ensure to develop that through knowledge. Communication is a very important aspect. It is not only about your written skill, your spoken skill, but also there is another element which is called non-verbal skill, and that is the ability to do active listening, have the right emotions, and also display the right facial expressions, the ability to use your body language to the advantage of better communication process and establish win-win relationship. So this is a very important aspect and can be a game changer in your career life. Creativity. What is creativity? When you are having certain knowledge, how do you apply that knowledge to do something of value and which is novel, something which has a competitive edge, and it is very interesting to all the stakeholders. Now, that is called value creation with creativity. This is also a very important aspect. And you can read books on Edward D. Bono to understand how creativity is as a process and develop that creativity faculty in you. So develop all these C's and definitely you will become a very connected person, because everything is through the online and offline connections that an individual gets in touch with another individual, and then there will be some job exchanges happening. So crack the job interview with character, competence, commitment, confidence, creativity, communication, and ensure that you are able to connect with that organization or interviewer. So that connection power is also very important. The fetish for communication is very vital. In fact, if you are communicating with an individual, it is surprising to note that 55% of the message transfer that happens from the message sender to the recipient is through body language. It is not through verbalization. It is not only through vocalization. 55% of the message transfer happens through body language. 38% of the message transfer happens through vocalization, the pitch, the pace, the pause, the emphasis that you give in different words when you are speaking. And finally, it is only the content that you are speaking. So obviously, this, which is called as the Albert Mehrabian formula, develops your communication skills and ensures that you will be able to crack the interview, or you will be able to go about doing the best of your abilities in the various assignments that you will be given. So focus on that. And when India is marching ahead as the pharmacy of the world, please understand what Indian pharma is doing so that you will be training your thought process to get engaged in those particular jobs. We are focusing on mainly doing the me-too products. Yes, we are not there in the high value chain where we are inventing new chemical entities. That is a long shot and that is a very complex process. But we are extremely good at reverse engineering, branding generics and sending them across the world. We are also into the biosimilar products, which uses recombinant DNA technology, producing monoclonal antibodies. There is a very vast market for bulk drugs, excipients, intermediates, herbal extracts and herbal formulations. In fact, in the toothpaste market, the sensitivity toothpaste and the herbal toothpaste are showing the largest or the highest amount of growth. We are also the masters of vaccines. So understand the science and technology behind all these sectors and you will become more required for the pharmaceutical industry. There is also the importing and marketing business, which is called contract marketing. And there is another CRAMS business, which is contract research and manufacturing services. Yes, if you have got the aptitude, you can also participate in various CROs, clinical research organizations. And also there are various aspects related to the exports, which you have to understand if you want to get into that sector. There are various terminologies like abbreviated new drug applications, COPP picks, etc. You know, very interestingly, today various companies are there in the media space which are focusing on pharmaceutical communication. They are looking for people who can add value in that through their written and spoken and knowledge skills. Internet companies like Practo, medical records companies are also there. Today, gamification of learning process, because please understand, pharma is a very dynamic sector, new molecules, new aspects about the same molecule, repurposing of the drugs, so many interesting developments constantly happen. So learning is a continuous process. And today, there various companies are there which do cloud software-based learning, gamification of learning, and so on. Market research companies, business analytics companies, they are all pharma focused, and it's one of the biggest sector. More than $1.5 trillion business is there in this healthcare across the world. Then there are companies called as pharmacovigilance, which try to find out what are all the adverse effects of products. And there are companies which focus on that. Packaging, sutures, various academic institutions, finishing school concept, veterinary products, which is not highly regulated, is a very booming sector. And interestingly, India is one of the largest producers of veterinary products. And yes, the nutraceuticals, food supplements, nutrition products is also rocking. There is an amazing growth opportunity because of the aging population, demand in the exports field, urbanization, demographics, and the domestic demand. We are also seeing that zoonotic diseases are increasing because the human and animal interaction is increasing. So there is a jumping of the pathogens from the animal world into the human world. So there is increased viral diseases trend, GI problems trend, consumption of addictive products, etc., which is contributing to the growth. So if you want to get into the pharmaceutical sector, I will put in red pharma sales and marketing, because the largest number of jobs which are created are in the pharmaceutical marketing field and sales field. For example, in group pharma, if you have got 100 jobs, out of that 100 jobs, at least 700 jobs are there in the sales and marketing field, and only 300 jobs are in the factory and in the administration space. So where are the most number of jobs being created? It is in the sales and marketing. So definitely think about it. There are other also fields which are there, R&D, manufacturing, QC, etc. So if you wish to get into the R&D, then you have to focus on understanding how to improve a formulation, because many people are focused today on improving their formulation profile. So learn how to do the basics on maybe making a syrup, suspension, etc. So this is a very important aspect if you are getting into R&D and biotech field. If you want to get into the manufacturing field, please understand pharmacists are the first preserve, but there are other MSCs, etc., who also get into pharma field in the manufacturing space. But you should know all these kind of terminologies, which includes GMP, Schedule M, PICS, etc. And you should be good at labor management. Quality jobs is also a very important aspect, because quality is the first and foremost thing in any pharmaceutical sector. A lot of MSCs, BSCs, etc. get into the quality sphere of pharma companies. So there, it is your ability to handle the various types of experimental machines, the various types of quality control equipment, understanding the quality assurance thinking, and also certain guidelines which are called as ICH. So if you are equipping yourself with this knowledge and then facing the interview board, your ability to get the job is more. And if you look at the regulatory sphere, which is really rocking today, a lot of people are there who are able to make what are called as technical dossiers, marketing dossiers. And this looks into the legal and other aspects related to the drug, the API, the excipient, the Ayush formulation or nutraceutical. And you will have to understand what the various regulatory agencies demand, and you have to develop the documentation for it. It is a skill which is not only related to document creation, but also communication process. If you have the verve for communication, good analytical skills, ability to absorb various technical issues and get a grip on it and understand, then regulatory sphere is for you. Yes, a lot of clinical services are also there where people are getting jobs, which is pharmacovigilance, clinical research, clinical industry aspects. So pharmaceutical industry is having a very good SWOT analysis, with the strength being our ability to produce affordable medications. There is a low cost of skilled manpower, large number of trained people like you, St. Josephites are there, who can give a lot of contribution to the pharmaceutical sector. And there is an increasing global demand for the generics, which is the preserve of the Indian pharmaceutical industry. And we are also going to the higher value chains. We are getting into the new space of inventing various products and drugs. There also we are doing. So obviously, pharmaceutical sector is something that you have to put in your checklist at the very top to see if you can get a job. Remember, marketing is the maximum job creator, and there is a good ladder of progress. Many of them turn into entrepreneurs, and you have got very good scope in the advertising industry, digital marketing, technical, etc. Life Sciences Sector Skill Development Council has said that the medical representative, who is a very, very important structural and functional unit of the organization, his description is, as per the Government of India's National Occupational Standards, to gather information about the product and the competitor products, sell the products to potential customers and provide after-sales service, organize medical conferences and promotional events. I have been there in this field for about 30 years. In this field, you will be meeting the best of the best. You will be transacting with the doctors. You will be transacting with the pharmacists. They are your universe. From morning till night, you will be engaged with the activities related to doctors and pharmacists, who are the cream of the society. So obviously, your ability also will go up because you move with the right crowd. This is one of the best fields you can ever get on the planet. So do consider pharmaceutical marketing. It is an international field. You will get international exposure. You will get assignments to go abroad. And you will also obtain very good growth in this field. The most sought after job skills in the marketing dimension particularly is English comprehension. Your ability to comprehend the technical matter, the pharmacology, etc. in English is very important. Deductive reasoning is important. Use the data to derive certain conclusions. Inductive reasoning is important, which means after seeing one particular episode or one experience, ability to translate it to the entire sphere. Like, for example, if an injection bottropace is being used for the veterinary field because thrombocytopenia cases are more, then ability to translate it as a national policy or a strategy to promote to all veterinarians. Now, that is an example of inductive reasoning. As a personality trait, you should be an agreeable personality. People should like you. That likability is very important to get success. You should enjoy being with people. I'm not asking you to be an extrovert, but at least extraversion should be there. And communication and thinking are very important. But if you are moving in the right sphere, you will be able to get the right vibrations to improve your thinking. So as per the skill map of India, software developers and sales professionals are having the maximum amount of jobs in the entire country. So please look into this sales and marketing field, because various technological trendings like digital health around the pill, digestible sensors, digital marketing, in silico testing, virtual reality and augmented reality, artificial intelligence assistant healthcare, 3D printing of drugs, precision medicine. These are all interesting technological trendings happening as I am speaking. Today, telehealth has increased. Patient engagement has increased. Real world evidence has increased. Deep learning and ADR monitoring is today happening. And in the quality sector, people are digitalizing all the paper processes. So have your digital skills ready. You should not be digital agnostic. And there should be quality assurance emphasis in your thinking. Lot of interesting trendings are happening in the nutraceutical field also. And Group Pharmaceuticals, which offers world-class manufacturing facility at Tarapur and also in Malur, which is near Bangalore. We have extraordinarily good facilities that comply with WHO, GMP, Schedule M, Schedule M Part 2, ISO, etc. So obviously, this is also a good choice. This company is also a very good employer organization, which is one of the very, very professional companies. And human resource trending, please understand, pharmaceutical sector, although has got the ability to absorb pharmacists, even non-pharmacists can get into it. Communication skill is of the highest priority, like English skill, deductive reasoning, inductive reasoning, being a team player, ability to grasp and being digitally savvy is very important. The future outlook, very positive, because this is a growth story and we are focusing on affordable and justifiable pricing. The insurance trending is increasing the market. Aging is also increasing the market. So Remember, this is ultra competitive, so it will keep you on your toes. And there is a lot of focus on doing novel products. And that's exactly what Group Pharma is doing. You can see our international range of products is highly accepted across the world. We got technologies by collaborating with various universities across the world, which are positioned also for the dental chairside procedures before, during, or after. And our patients are also having the option of very good flavors, which are all developed within the R&D of our company. So you have got four good flavors of this pediatric toothpaste. This is an extraordinary mouthwash, which has got a very good feel factor and protective against the COVID-19 also by reducing the viral load. Our company is focused on CSR, and this also makes us well accepted into the dental field. We have always introduced various novel products such as the Rocking Densi, which has had a very good opening. These are the world's first color-changing denture cleansing tablets on which we have a patent to render the dentures aseptic as well as without any stains. So you will appreciate that this company has got a lot of focus on using technology for improving the healthcare with its color-changing perborate and PMPS technology. So we are partnering dentists as a company to create healthy smiles and laughter. Talking of smile, so in the University of California, Berkeley, they studied the class photos of Mills College. Some girls, they smile genuinely, you know, the smile which reaches up to the eyes, that is called Duchenne smile. It is both involuntary and voluntary muscle. And this observational study for 30 years landed up with a very interesting insight. The researchers who tracked them for 30 years found that the genuine smilers were blessed with happier lives in terms of marriage, well-being, and career. So what does it mean? That you should learn how to be a Duchenne smile maker so that you will have a very good career, because finally it is about the moral quality, the character, the competence. These are all the pictures of genuine smilers. So Duchenne smile and non-Duchenne smile are both shown here. And one of the reasons why Obama was very successful was his ability to come across as a very honest individual. This non-Duchenne smile is also called as a Pan Am smile. So the air hostess always gives you a very pretty smile, but it's non-Duchenne. It is not original. It is a fake smile. She looks so beautiful, isn't it? But it's a very fake smile that she is sporting. So please understand, smiling and laughing makes you feel much better, reduces the inflammation in your body, the feel-good hormones like dopamine, endorphins increase in your body and you feel good and success comes to you. Remember to read these two interesting books, An Unfinished Agenda by Dr. K. Anji Reddy. You have all heard of Dr. Reddy Labs. He is the one who has, this is an autobiography of Dr. Anji Reddy, who established Dr. Reddy Labs. Fantastic book, very thrilling. You will understand the pharmaceutical industry. And also you can read the book of the Indian biotechnology industry through the myth maker, that is Kiran Majumdar Shah. So obviously you are on a strong wicket if you choose the pharmaceutical sector. Various career options are there. Give a high order importance for the pharmaceutical sales and marketing. Thank you very much. Over to Dr. Lokesh.
Thank you, Dr. Lokesh. Thank you, Chipunka, sir. I am sharing my screen. Please confirm. Okay. Is it better now? My audio? Yeah, it's visible in full screen mode. Yeah, good. Thank you, Sunil Chipunka, sir. Thank you, Lokesh, sir. And all the distinguished faculty and members of St. Joseph's and the students. It's my pleasure to be with you this morning. And I, Mr. Sunil Chipunka, already spoke to you. And in our earlier session also, we talked about the pharmaceutical industry. And the pharmaceutical industry of India today is the pharmacy of the world. You have seen it last 2 years that COVID-19 the solutions emerged from India. Even the developed world was dependent on India to supply their vaccines. We have hit the mark of 1 billion vaccines within India. All this is achievement of pharmaceutical industry. And along with our scientists, manufacturing teams, one team who is working all the time to make it happen is the pharmaceutical sales and marketing teams. Before I talk more about the pharmaceutical sales and marketing, let's go back to the Brian Tracy, the world's most renowned motivational speaker. He describes sales as the ultimate default career. And why is he saying so? If you look at any business, any profession, any venture, it is dependent on selling. Whether we sell ideas, we sell our thoughts, or we sell products or services, selling is everywhere. Even to sell an idea to a child, mother is using selling techniques. To put you to studies or to eat something that you don't like, your parents have used sales techniques. Selling is an ultimate default career, right from politicians to managers to even the teachers. Everywhere, it is the default career. Why choose sales as a career? Selling offers the enormous earning potential. The income in sales is dependent on your own performance. Another advantage of selling as a career is flexibility to schedule work. Office goer or production worker needs to report 7 to 7 o'clock in the morning and continues till 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. He may be required in the night time. But, and this is the same routine they have to follow for 25, 30, 40 years as long as they are working. But that is not so in sales. In sales, one day we might hit the road at 7 o'clock. We make our own work plans. We make our own days plans at the convenience of doctors or our customers and our own. So there is some amount of flexibility. Selling offers the maximum job security. Is different from other goods. Yes, sir? Hello? Yeah?
Okay. Am I clear? Okay, I'll hold the mic. How pharmaceutical selling is different from other goods selling? You might have seen the soaps, you might have seen the furniture salesman. Now, a soap salesman or pan salesman has to go shop to shop. They may have to knock the doors of households. But pharmaceutical selling involves meeting professionals who are well-versed, who are educated, pharmacists and doctors. It is different than selling on the streets. It is different than selling home to home. The customers in pharma industry are well respected, and they also treat knowledgeable salesmen with respect. A person with integrity and values earns the respect of customers. Moreover, pharmaceutical selling is also a service to mankind. All the medicines that we use today are available in the nooks and corners of India. It is way different than the situation in 80s and before that. Many of the medicines were not available in remotest villages of India. With the companies like Dr. Reddy's, Ranbaxy, Sun Pharma, Mankind, with army of medical representatives working everywhere. These companies have between 10 to 20,000 medical representatives. Every village, every nook and corner of the country, all the latest medicines are made available. It is not only just making medicines available, but explaining the nurses, the doctors, and the pharmacists how to use those medicines. What is the appropriate way of using them? All this knowledge, to a large extent, is imparted by medical representatives. What growth opportunities pharmaceutical sales offers? Generally, the sales career begins with a trainee medical representative in a pharmaceutical industry. And what is the qualification required? It is the good character and communication skills. If you are a graduate, very good, but it is not must. If you are a pharmacy graduate, even better, but not a must. During trainee medical representative program, all the applicants are earning and learning under Prime Pradhan Mantri Skills Yojana. And then after successful completion of the course, they become full-time medical representative, the permanent medical representative. Then they graduate to field sales officers or senior medical representatives. And then they become area business managers or area managers. Typically, a trainee medical rep or full-time medical rep, permanent medical rep will be responsible for a small area. But as he grows, the area becomes bigger. Typically, at the area business manager, you will have 5 to 7 representatives reporting to you. You are now learning to manage people. And then you graduate to zonal business manager or regional manager. A zonal business manager will typically have 3 to 5 area managers and 15 to 30 medical representatives under him. And then zonal business managers report to divisional sales managers. A divisional sales manager may look half of India or full India and may have anywhere between 100 to 500 medical reps, maybe 40 to 50 area managers, 10 zonal business managers. And then they graduate to become sales directors. The illustrious career of many of the national managers, divisional managers, including Mr. Chipunkar, who is now Vice President Business Development, and me, we all started as medical representative at some point of our journey. Some of the medical representatives decide to go to marketing side, that's the brand management. The openings to brand management or marketing are again through medical representative roles. The successful medical representatives who are very strong in product knowledge and communication get opportunities in product management teams, where typically they start as regional product executives or junior product executives or product specialists. And they execute, they graduate to become product executives, product managers, or brand managers. In this marketing, they are handling brands. Whereas in sales, you are handling areas, states, zones, and they are interconnected at all levels. The brand managers graduate to marketing managers, business development managers, sales admin managers, distribution managers are some of the parallel roles that sales management teams get as they earn the experience and the knowledge of different areas. So the growth opportunities are plenty in pharmaceutical selling and marketing, and the starting point is the medical representative. That's where we all learn the nitty-gritties of the profession and the requirements. And as you learn, as you grow, as you earn experience, you can keep growing. How pharmaceutical selling career adds to your own personality development? Mr. Sunil Chipulankar already spoke some points. The best one in this is network your network is your net worth. The more connected you are, the more connections you have. The connections in the pharma industry all begin with connections in the medical industry. The doctors, the hospital owners, the pharmacists, the distributors, the wholesalers. It's a big long chain, and it all begins. The connections start building when you are starting in sales. The pharmaceutical salesmen are groomed specially for dressing sense, the appropriate dressing. You will always find them impressively. A professional representative is always well-dressed. And he is also sharp in his communication, in his language and the voice. Pharmaceutical selling on the street teaches you what they don't teach you in Harvard. The problem-solving, practical mindset. And another important aspect of it is understanding of the human behavior. Once you understand, today we have programs who are understanding how we use the screens, but the people developing them have a very deep understanding of human behavior. And the selling profession is one such profession where we get to know how to understand humans, how to understand different behavior, and how to apply it in selling and marketing. While I'm talking about what sales is offering, there is also something I should tell you, that sales profession is not for those who do not love traveling. When you are a medical representative, you are traveling in a smaller area of maybe 20 kilometers, 10 kilometers. But as you grow in sales and marketing, the traveling increases. We love living in our suitcase. It is a profession where there is a continuous churn. Every day new products are coming. Every day new technologies are being developed. There are newer ways of developing and learning. The way we used to shop before and now it is changing. And so this is a profession where continuous learning is a necessity. So if you are not interested in learning continuously, this is not a profession for you. And also, if you are looking for a rapid career growth and earning, this is the profession. And if it is not your priority, please don't join the sales career. In detail about what a medical representatives do. A joining criteria is generally diploma in pharmacy or graduation in any stream. Since the job involves traveling, a driving license is a must, two-wheeler preferred. What the recruiters look for when you are joining as a medical representative? Excellent communication skills in oral as well as written, preferably in English language along with regional language. Excellent grasping and learning. Your own self-discipline, your own character. Because a sales representative, medical work plans, his own travel plans. So all this requires a tremendous self-discipline and a drive to grow, without which a sales representative will not become a successful medical sales representative. What medical representative does? The job involves meeting doctors, pharmacists, stockists, wholesalers, and other customers. He is responsible for meeting customers every day and also responsible for achieving sales objectives. He promotes different products as per the training imparted. He is always well-dressed, professionally dressed, and maintains the dignity of the profession. Apart from meeting day-to-day doctors and chemists, medical representatives get opportunities to attend exhibitions, conferences, the medical conferences, and also training sessions for the select medical representatives. The basic training is given to all medical representatives. But as you grow, as you earn experience, you get opportunities to attend finer trainings, trainings on body language, trainings on communication skills, trainings on science. These opportunities are given to successful, disciplined medical representatives. And the more you learn, more you grow in this profession, because you earn the respect of the medical community because of your knowledge. What is the earning potential? Typically, medical representative starting salary in most organizations is between 12,000 to 15,000, 17,000 per month. Is that all? No, that's your salary. You also get daily allowances ranging between 150 to 200 rupees a day that takes care of petrol and tiffin. Plus, you get some fixed allowances like stationery allowance, communication allowance that includes your telephone and internet. You get some other allowances, and from time to time when you are called for travel training programs, you get, or you are going out of station, you get even hotel allowance or overnight stay allowances. So all that makes a medical professional or medical representative jobs interesting. Apart from this, on achievement of sales targets, medical representatives earn very handsome lucrative incentives. We have cases where medical representatives have taken bikes within the first year of joining. And the seasoned, successful medical representatives have built their own homes and have even earned their four-wheelers through incentives. I'm giving some examples. Some of them you might have known. You know all Starbucks. And who took over Starbucks? It is Howard Schultz. He joined as a sales representative at the age of 25 and became CEO by 35. He started as a salesman in Xerox, and then he joined Starbucks as director of marketing, and he became CEO in 87 within a span of just 10 years. If you have heard about Warren Buffett and his investment company, he is the world's top 5 richest men, and in 5 years, in 20 years, he became world's top 5. How? He also started as a salesman and as a paper boy. Another fellow, he's from the pharmaceutical industry, William Weldon. He joined as a sales representative in Johnson & Johnson. All of you must have known Johnson & Johnson, right from baby soaps to various pharmaceutical products are from Johnson & Johnson, including some life-saving drugs. He became head of operations in 1998, and by 2002, he became the CEO of the company where he joined as a salesman. So the career opportunities that I discussed in the beginning of the slide is not just for telling you, but there are practical, real-life examples, case studies who have grown. Is it only in abroad? No. We have even here Mr. R.C. Juneja. You must have seen Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's advertisement advertising some of his pharmaceutical products. How he started? He was just a science graduate. He started his career in 1974 with Key Pharma as a medical representative and joined Lupin in 75. And he became area manager within the first year and continued as area manager, frontline manager, as for 8 years. That's where he learned. It is the foundation that he got. He resigned in 83. Today, his company, Mankind Pharma, is ranked number one in prescription-generated products in the pharma industry and overall among top 5 pharma companies of India. What a journey of a company. And what a journey of Mr. R.C. Juneja, who started as a medical representative in 74, and he started a company in 83, from 83 to 2022, a company that is in top five in India. There are many examples, including Mr. Sunil Attawar, our current chairman and managing director. He started his career as a medical representative in another pharmaceutical company as Helios and became area manager there and learned the ropes of the industry before taking over the reins of Group Pharma. So the pharmaceutical industry is starting point in the sales and the career begins with the medical representative. Why pharmaceutical selling is field is so popular? The pharmaceutical sales field is called recession proof. You must have heard the job losses happened in many sectors, but pharmaceutical industry is recession proof. In fact, the employment opportunities in pharma industry grew multifold even during COVID. It offers excellent earning potential, great benefits, flexibility, and tremendous opportunities to grow. The perks are even visiting different cities and countries. Like Mr. Sunil Chipurunkar and myself, we have got opportunities to work in not only India, but even in some other countries also. The pharmaceutical industry offers the various opportunities that you can see. It is an opportunity, a mine of gold mine of opportunities. To summarize, why join Group Pharma? As Group Pharma, in Group Pharma, we have innovated over 8 times launches. Pharma industry is growing and oral care is among the top 20 segments in the pharma industry today. Oral health is now going to grow even more. We have more dentists, almost 3 lakh dentists, and we have less than 3 lakh general doctors, MBBS doctors. So if you join Group Pharma, you are joining a very rapidly growing segment. And if the growth is rapid in the industry, in the segment, it also provides you a lot of growth opportunities. In Group Pharma, we believe tremendously in learning and development. Every person in this company undergoes minimum 200 hours of training. Imagine 200 hours of training. What it difference it makes to your own personality and growth and knowledge base. So we have that learning and culture, and that provides you one more reason why you should join Group Pharma. Because in the starting of the career, it is the foundation that you get, the knowledge, the learning and growth opportunities. The first 3-4 years make you industry ready, make you shape your career and development and growing the talent within. To conclude, we always talk, we have made from our PM Lal Bahadur Shastri a slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. We have soldiers at the borders to protect us. We have the Kisan, the farmers to grieve, to generate our staples, the food. But it is the salesman who takes the goods produced in the factory to the nooks and corners of the country. So Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Salesman. Thank you.
Thank you, Lokesh sir. Just a moment, please. I have shared with you a WhatsApp that gives us details of how to apply. I would appreciate if it can be shared to all the students who are willing to join us. Thank you. Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of School of Life Sciences, I cordially welcome Mr. Praveen Kumar, the Marketing Executive of Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited, to our placement drive. Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited was founded and is run by Mr. Vincent Matthew, an alumni of SJC. Established in 2013, the company now holds a worth of over 15 crores. Their services are custom solution and bulk procurement with diversified consumable range covering all spheres of life sciences, including pharmaceutical and diagnostic industry. Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited is now one of the leading sourcing partners of life sciences in Karnataka. Now, I request Mr. Praveen to oblige us with his valuable words.
Thank you, Jyoti Smita. Thank you, Dr. Lokesh. Thank you, Mr. Kiran, sir. This is an honor, and being back to Joseph as an alumni and ex-Josephite, me and my director, Vincent Mather, both, now previously, Mr. Lakshmikant sir and Sunil sir have clearly explained what sales job more or less like and how the pharmaceutical industry and how the medical representative works and willing to travel and benefits. So everything is clearly in detail explained. So here, what would I like to talk about is our experience from Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited. So we started our career after our master's as a sales representative with various pharma companies, yes, as Dr. Sunil and Lakshmikant sir told. And in 2013, we started a small company called Juniper Life Sciences. It was a proprietary company. So initially, we only focused on molecular biology. So I think you people are more aware about RT-PCR, PCR, and DNA synthesis. So we started marketing and selling these products to scientists, various institutions and companies. So where we procure these products from various brands, from international brands to all over Indian brands. And then we started marketing and sales. So we majorly this entire company is about sales and marketing. So I would like to share the screen. Can you see? Yeah, 1 minute. Can it be seen? Okay. So this is how we started our journey. So once we start, as previously they told, so once you start exposing yourself and experiencing with engaging with a lot of different types of people and different clients and different customers with different mindset, thoughts and everything, so you start improving yourself as a personality. As a person, you start improving in your communication skill, in your understanding, in your potential and everything. So this is where it triggered us. Why couldn't we start a company? So while we were a sales representative, it was a different thing. But while we became an entrepreneur journey, while we took an entrepreneur journey, it was a different experience. Because here it was, it's more of 24/7 kind of job. But all this experience we can gain only when we start exposing ourselves into the field. So ready to travel, all weather, ready to go out, speak to people, cold calls. So this is where we started in 2013. But right now, Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited is, as Akanksha told, so it's almost 15 crore company within the span of 8 years. So we are still growing. We are getting more brands into our portfolio. We are getting more different products into our portfolio, where pharmaceutical is one of the part of our portfolio. So we are more diversified in our customer base with research, testing, agriculture, horticulture, diagnostic industries, nutraceuticals, so variety of different fields where we are engaging with. And we are into the fields of microbiology, cell biology, biochemistry, all types of chemicals, media, sera, reagents. So as salesperson, you will be exposing yourself to a lot of knowledge. So you will be able to understand all these technical terms, all these products, why it is used. Because you're engaging with scientists, you're engaging with doctors, you're talking to them, you're understanding about the usage of it. So you're overall improving your knowledge and skill altogether. So now we have almost 15 employees with us. So this is a small company. So we are trying to grow. In 2 years, we are expecting to be around 30 employee people employed in our company, and almost 30 crore turnover. This is what our target is. So right now we are based in Electronic City. So we have around 10,000 square feet of inventory, where we have almost 1,000 SKU, 1,000 products with us. So it's annual turnover is around 15 crore right now. So last year it was 10 crore. Right now, to this year, it's 15 crore. So it was an exponential growth. In this COVID period, there were a lot of test, antigen, PCR test, all these products. So there were a lot of demand, which increased our portfolio also. So if you see, our mission is to bridge various scientific endeavors timely and flexibly to further research, testing, and service for the humanity. So what we basically do is we are sourcing partner. So we connect manufacturers to the end users. We connect manufacturers to the another manufacturer. So B2B business is what we do. So it is, as previously told, it is not a sales to the common person. It's to the technical, scientific person. So the ability to sell the product, you need to have the scientific understanding. So BSc and MSc graduates, so will be really apt in taking this field for faster growth. So another important point which I would like to say is there's a huge gap between academical understanding and industrial requirement. So this is mainly because innovation is happening faster at industry level. So if you see in our business itself, the products which we were selling 2 years before, we are no more selling it. So the chemicals or the products has been improved or changed. So right now, when the new products are introduced, you need to understand the product. You need to understand the specifications, compositions, and why it is used, how it is used. This is how you can actually, with this knowledge, you can engage with our clients, customers, and that's how you can sell the product too. So you have to keep yourself informed on almost regular basis. So previously they have listed out each and every point very clearly, but I would like to say in terms of sales, so there is a cliche that sales job is so hard, paining, and it's very difficult. You have to go around in sun and things and all. But this is the place where growth happens faster, and it is flexible. It is it improves the overall personality in a far faster way. So right now, when we talk about, as Dr. Lokesh has initially communicated with us, so this presentation is more of job vacancy that we have and how Josephites can apply. So right now, what we have is two vacancy in Bangalore for area sales executive. So you can, the role definition and role and responsibility will be brief while your CV resumes are applied with us. So what we are offering is 2.4 lakh per annum plus perks. That is 20K per month. And perks will include travel allowances, insurance, incentives, and other allowances. So, and the place is located in Electronic City. So the sales executive has to be willing to work in any assigned territory within Bangalore as of now. The recruitment process will be a screening process where there will be first round of interview, second round, and then shortlisting, and final round there will be a presentation to be given the employee. So, and then there will be only two openings as of now, and offer will be provided. So we, as a Josephites, ex-Josephites, so we prioritize here, as now this is like getting back to Josephs. So we are hoping to get more Josephites into Juniper Life Sciences Private Limited. So any details, you can contact Mr. Lokesh, or you can note down the email ID at marketing@juniperlifesciences.com, or directly you can contact vincent.m@juniperlifesciences.com to submit your CVs. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So thank you. So thank you very much, sir, for that presentation and to all those speakers. It was very good. And I'm sure many students are going to benefit from this. We will also continue to share this information to our 2021 batch. And also we have a huge number of students in the 2022 batch who are also ready to take up this role. So it's something that we would definitely desire. College is now in the verge of, you know, working with different organizations to create partnerships with them to see how we can work further from both educational perspective and from the employment perspective. So again, I'm sure we'll be able to get in touch with you through Lokesh sir to see how we can partner with each other for a long-term association with the college so that we could have a good relationship with you and more students from St. Joseph's be hired into this. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Dr. Lokesh, sir. Yeah, I just want to make a point or two. First of all, thank you. It is a very good initiative, Dr. Lokesh sir, and your colleagues you are taking, particularly because kids require this sort of a platform to inspire themselves. See, these kids don't know anything about how to go about getting a job. What do we do? What qualities we need to have? They only know how to study in a syllabus and then pass the examination. But the real examination comes outside. Every day is an examination. Every day we get our question paper. Okay. So now in Bangalore, Group Pharmaceuticals has got openings for 15 medical representative positions because of an expansion plan. So each medical representative would have to cover around 200 doctors, manage the productive relationship with 200 doctors to get around a business of rupees 1,000 from each doctor. So we will give them the training, the different strategic inputs and the guidelines to obtain this business. If the person is even a BSc, you know, fail with one or two subjects and he is in the final year, we are ready to recruit that person. He can then take a leave on that particular day to write the exam, the supplementary exam. So we are open to that sort of recruitment also. And there will be, of course, an interview process, and through that, the recruitment will be done. So outstation candidates, because Jesuit organizations are there across the India, I think. So if any outstation candidate, like, for example, Kolar or any other place wants to work in Bangalore in this particular position and wants to apply, we can help in getting a paying guest accommodation also from the company side. And sometimes deserving cases in our organization are considered for a two-wheeler loan also. So these are the offerings from Group Pharmaceuticals. Lokesh, sir, over to you.
We can wind up, sir. We can wind up, sir. Thank you. So, is it possible for the presentation to be shared, sir? Okay, sir.
I will send the PDF.
Okay, sure, no sir. Problem. We can share it to some students, yes.
Yeah, good. Keep it up, Dr. Lokesh. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Thank you.
Thank you.